If you have recently gone gluten-free and are struggling with recipe ideas for a gluten-free diet, then I have many. Ravneet Bhalla posts a lot of recipes that are gluten-free, healthy and nutritious. And I have already shared many gluten-free recipes on the channel, from cookies to cakes, rotis to parathas. You will love it all. And I have also shown how to make your own gluten-free flours at home. And this bajra laddu with dates recipe is also gluten-free. Moong dal cookies tasted so very, very yum. Jawar muli roti is coming today. Let's make jawar muli parantha before winter bids adieu and muli or radish disappears from the market. So for this recipe, you need muli grated and squeeze out all the water from muli or radish once you grate it out. And then add ajwain or karam seeds, jeera or cumin seeds, kasturi methi, salt and red pepper powder. And now add 1 tablespoon of besan. You can increase the amount of besan or completely eliminate it if you don't like its flavor, but besan or chickpea flour really lifts the flavor of this recipe. I always add it to my muli paranthas. Now let's make jowar dough first. Boil 1/2 cup of water. And once it comes to a boil, add 1/2 cup and 1/4 cup of jowar flour or sorghum atta. Mix quickly until it comes together as dough, and you will need to cook it until it comes together as dough. I have already shared the recipe to make jowar roti without breaking. Do check out that recipe if you want to learn how to make the right dough for your jowar roti. Now keep it aside for 10 to 30 minutes, and after 30 minutes you will be ready to make jowar muli ki roti or jowar muli parantha with it. Take a ball, press it gently, and then add the filling that we have made, prepared, and check if the filling has water. If it is watery, then you can squeeze a little amount of water. You can squeeze the water and then add as filling. Muli always releases water, and once you add salt, it again releases water. So always squeeze it when you add water, and then adjust the consistency of salt accordingly. Now press gently with hand, be very gentle, and don't forget to dust the surface with flour, because this is muli parantha and it will stick. Continue to press, roll with hands. And it is easier to roll with hands, and my mom makes muli makki ki roti just following this process with hands only, and she is an expert in that. I have already shared the recipe to make makki muli ki roti, which is also a gluten-free parantha, so do check it out. I'll be sharing the link in the description box as well. Now put it on the tawa or skillet and then cook it on a low flame first. Whenever you make any parantha or even roti, cook it on low flame first. That will ensure even cooking, even heating, and it will give you softer chapatis and even softer paranthas. So this is the trick I have learned from my mother-in-law. Now flip this side once it looks slightly cooked. Flip this side, and now you can turn the flame to medium or high. Flip this side, apply some oil. And the amount of oil you want to apply depends completely on you. You can be generous with oil, or you can choose to be mean with it as well, just like me. I don't apply too much oil on my paranthas, but my typical breakfast is parantha. Usually I have paranthas only, sometimes dosas, sometimes idli, upma, but primarily it is parantha. So now cook on both sides, flip, cook on both sides, apply oil on both sides, and it will be cooked in a jiffy. And I'm sure you will really love this jowar muli ki roti. Do leave me a comment how you find this recipe and how the muli parantha with jowar looks like. I hope you like this sorghum flour recipe. If you do, please hit the like button, and if you do not, you can hit the dislike button. And